One of my last things came back with an episode of Ultimate Alma Dreadnoughts. We are obliterating the French. They don't really stand much chance due to the Italian ground forces having just so much funding behind them and the utter obliteration of the French Navy. The Germans have almost essentially given up on trying to even build ships at this point. I think a lot of their ships being trapped just stalled and without fuel. This is the reason why they're not really building ships, because they just have so many ships available. Pushing into eastern Germany from southern Germany, splitting Germany in half. Now, another nation I could really mess with if I decided to fight them is the Russians. Ground warfare for them would be absolute hell. They don't have that much army and logistics, they don't have that big of a navy, they have a massive country I could steal from them. They do have 2 million, almost 3 million armed forces. Problem is, those armed forces are going to be poorly supplied. And with Africa basically my sole dominion, some British territory is held, but with this much Africa in my control, theoretically, if I somehow magically lost my entire navy, I would have a lot of land routes to supply me back into the homeland. Just through this alone. And that research is coming up. We also hit late radar tech, meaning I no longer have to hard focus this radar anymore, as it's now just a passive bonus that is just added on to the tech. Which I do like how it reveals itself when it's, oh, you've essentially reached the end of the tree. I don't think I'm getting the Dominican Republic, unfortunately. The Dominican Island. I think the British are going to steal that. I'm trying to steal it from them, so they're going to rightfully win it. I start hard focusing on naval communications, as that is the one thing I kind of want more of, is to be able to increase the size of fleets, as our battleships are getting to massive sizes, and I want to be able to build them easily. Now the Germans are kind of desperately trying to piece me out, and it's like, no, I'll eat your country. Okay, they're double attempting to peace, as both the country and the admiral is like, please, let me out of this war, please, 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 please. Our ground forces probably have that. pretty easy. I can go try still the other French islands and stuff. I kind of want to check if that is the next level of oil. So I'll wait a couple turns until I can see what that is. French Navy also has it ceased to exist. Essentially. That's 16 ships. It has less ships than Germany now. Alright, now it's time for the massive refit order. Because I'm still using all of these vessels. Plus, I'm using this design as well. Although this design is going to get modernized. I've kept it essentially to its original design specifications. But now it's going to get... I'm going to rip basically all the guns off. And re-update it. And keep its turbo electric engines. Then you go from third third armor to fifth, which has reduced its tonnage by 44,000. When you increase the barbette size, anti-torque 4, triple bottom hull, from Citadel 2 to Citadel 4. I'm going to remove its torpedo torps. Yes, torpedo torps, torpedo tubes. As that is, on battleships, it's not really, like, we don't really get into knife fighting range with them that often. It's not really useful to have torpedoes on board. The weight constraints, I do have to downsize this to a single barrel. Although single barrels do reload faster. Had to sacrifice armor in some areas. But now we have most likely a better spotting distance. But yeah, spotting range of 30,000 meters. Then we have a gun that shoots 36,000 meters. Some armor scheme got pushed around. The armament has been upgraded from 14-inch guns to 16.9. The secondaries are upgraded from 2s to 3.9s. The 3.9s seem to be very effective, no matter what the time period is. I believe the AP shields do a lot more damage on just standard AP. It's 1,800, and then on standard it is 2,400. So, like, when these things actually pin, like, they'll do a lot more damage because there's a lot more explosive power in the shell. I'll probably be starting to switch over to that, because we're getting to such large calibers, armor just kind of doesn't matter anymore. Because, like, ships have to be, like, to the insane level of armor that I'm putting on my ship everywhere on board to actually resist getting hit. Of the 16.9s. And the only one that I'm remotely possibly might be able to do that is Britain. But as we've seen with the French designs, where their armor is non-existent. Alright, that's the first redesign gone through. Here comes the next redesign. Because I'd rather refit these old hulls, because they'll take about 5 months to do so, than build a brand new hull that takes like 3 years. Rip all of its armor right off. So we plan to do a redesign of the armament itself. We'll be keeping all that stuff on board. So we're gonna go from 20 to 19. And probably a lot more, it would have been a lot more weight save because of it would have reduced the turret weight. Again, this is another one that has torpedoes on board, which I'm going to out remove them. Oh, this one also might be just getting a single turret instead of having duels. For the single barrel turrets. Now I gotta up armor the turrets. Because I plan around having the most armor on these things as possible. I gotta find 28 tons worth of hull to remove. Again, a lot a lot of these ships are just getting revamped and redesigned outright. Like, this one is going to be quick, simple, is that I'm not going to be able to change out the gun from, like, 11 to 12. It's going to get the modernizations that I've invented. Which saved a little bit of weight right there. But it will be going from level 3 armor to level 5 armor. From level 1 citadel to level 4 citadel. Brand new depth charges. Radio detection finder and a level 3 radar. Sacrificing range. True question is, do I want to pull off torpedoes? No, I think I'm going to keep torpedoes on the heavy cruisers. The 11s will keep their capped ballistics due to I can't ever add a better gun to this. And this is just to ensure the 11s can pin. No matter what. Oh, what can I strip? I'll just strip some of the superstructure. Thank you. Now, I think this will be the last set of refits for a long while. Or at least cruisers and other things like that. Like, the battleships might get refitted again. If there is a gun update where like I can get 18-inch guns or like 17-inch guns, I feel like refitting the other battleships. Like the bigger ones that could easily change out to the fatter hulls. Like the Grenada or whatever, the G class will never be able to fit a heavier gun on it than what I've gotten it. It's set of secondaries. I don't feel any dis actually. I got Citadel once on this. Citadel four time. Now, their armor is not the best on these updated, refitted models. But it's not meant to be the best. It's meant for these things to be able to long-range people. The Italia is going to have a massive redesign of its secondaries as there has been a revamp on how our secondary design philosophy works. Which is as many 3.9s as possible. I got 1,000 tons to play with. Yeah, but with the 10-inch aft deck and an 8-inch main deck, depending on what type of shell they're shooting and if the calculations are all right, we not get pinned through the top deck anymore, or well, through the rear deck. Oh yes, this is another ship that has torpedoes. Let me remove those. As the capital ships no longer need torpedoes like this, saving us some weight. We're losing a lot of internal plating or external plating. This is also another 6 month rebuild. Another massive vessel that's going to need a refit. Now, does this have the updated gun scheme? Yes, it does. Save 4,000 tons. Well, it's not going to get the updated secondaries with the triple barrel secondaries, but it doesn't really need it. Already has 8 million secondaries to begin with. Oh yeah, we need to go to Citadel 4. This is where the complicated part of this refit comes in. I might have to start sacrificing speed. Due to this one not having to rip out basically all of their turrets and replace them, and we're just keeping the same amount of turrets, this one is actually going to not have to refit that fast. It's also going to save a lot of money month-wise due to I reduced the speed on the ship using a turbo electric engine. This one shouldn't need an update either, really. Or a massive update either, compared to of Doctrine. Although we'll be going from be going down to standard shells. Also ripping that shaft improvement out. So update it in the armor scheme, and I completely forgot to update the other two parts or the reasons why this update is happening. Although this design is going to be able to keep its speed than the other ones. I want to compare from Hydra 1 to 2 distance that we tech to Praetor. Basically, we can tech them 2 kilometers out, which might give us just enough time to dodge, even in this thing. Because we can just throw it back into reverse with the turboelectric engine. And not break our engines doing that. And this thing is hyper resistant toward torpedoes and mines. Plus with the hyper thick belt, torpedoes shouldn't do that much damage in the first place. So Citadel tech has not been advanced that far when this design was made, so we've actually advanced pretty far in being able to protect our internals. Oh, I just never updated the design. I was very confused. I'm not building that. I'm building the other one. The funny thing is, I do have to update the mining destroyer. Thing is hyper obsolete using an old hull. I can't even build this hull anymore. Apparently this thing is the best anti-submarine boat in the universe. 704 anti-submarine warfare. And 300% or 300 recon. No armor, no gun. This is exactly what this thing was designed for, is be cheap as physically possible. And spot the thing trying to spot you before it spots you. I think the lag from saving is not sta it's lagging from the save, it's lagging because it has to load all the images of the other ships. This massive chonker of a vessel. Then you update to its armor. Strips off 4,000 tons. It already has Citadel 4 and a triple bottom, so I don't have to actually account for that. It is using the 14.9s and the 16.9s. Engine bursting charge 3. Brand new radar system. Brand new hydrophone. Gonna force it up to 22 knots, so it has like a running speed of 19 to 20. with more mountain refit, although it will be going faster than its original version, and it will be with its updated systems. Now that's just refit the existing fleet that I have, which I'll probably do before I do any more operations after I steal the rest of the French colonies. I will then summon the fleets back to their ports and do a massive refit campaign. I do like how the other thing is considered the best anti-submarine ship in existence, while this one is considered pretty all right. Things also detect, barely can detect things out of its detectability, which is pretty bad. Although it does have a lot of torpedo tubes on board. It loses 3 knots, comes a little bit less ranged, has bigger, fatter torpedoes, and going about 13 kilometers, making the torpedoes a lot easier to launch Hearts have no armor. Chip is still the best armor physically possible. A month refit. So I have made a refit version of everything. I'll get out of the screen and I will be throwing all these other refit versions into the trash so the game will stop freezing so hard when it sees a fleet design, the fleet design menu. Pair these together. Yeah, it's doubling the maintenance of it. Yeah, because that reduced it down the three, down by 3 knots. Caused it to be like 10 mil cheap, over 10 mil cheaper. Thank you. Losing a bit of speed, this actually became cheaper than its original. Alright, so we're gonna have to do a brand new redesign of both Battleship, Destroyer, and Cruiser. Actually, I might leave the redesign of the Destroyer alone for a bit, because that tech might come through. I don't need to. I'll redesign the Destroyer once I need it. But not a second before. Actually, I'm gonna do that with the Cruiser too. The only reason I'm not gonna do that with the Battleship is the Battleship requires to be designed right now and start construction on it right now because of how long it takes to build it. And the standardization for speed is the 22 knots for fleet base so far. Couple ships go a little bit faster, but usually it is 22 knots. But I do love how we've kept a cruiser and a battleship from 1915 and 1916 just around for forever. And they probably will remain around until either they're sunk, because of how long it takes to build them. But anyway, that'll be it for this episode. Next time we'll be designing the brand new battleship. But that is it for now. If you like the video, please like, comment, subscribe. And come hang out in the Discord. Peace!